Of this bar are fantastic guys. It's the Wayland at 9th and Avenue C in the East Village, and you gotta come here and have a drink. They make the most amazing drinks, they make great food. Very first thing was a meeting to understand what they wanted, what they were looking for. Yes, there's the size, the exact measurements, how far away is comfortable for their behind to be, to have room for the bar, but it was more the aesthetic and what they were looking for. That the first meeting is getting a total energy understanding the meeting of the minds. We had a meeting of the minds, and
dimensions and size, very key. Do you want the bar wide? You need to have at least an 8 to 11 inch overhang on the front, so that the seating, your stool height and your knees don't hit the wall. Very specific, built from the beginning of time, sizes had to be incorporated. The size of the bar being 24 inches wide, not having the bartenders reach too far to get the drinks, not being the distance between the ice machines underneath and getting the ice and not hitting the bar to come out. All these dimensions are so key. That and them being bartenders, they knew what they wanted.
Build this bar, it took about 3 or 4 days to build the form and the structure on it. You know, 2 or 3 days to build the form, which is the structure that holds the bar. Framing, the designing, the sizing, the distances away, mapping out. Every inch was accounted for the depth behind to give them comfortable space to work behind the bar, how much they wanted to give up in front of the bar to make it comfortable to work behind, yet the maximum size for the patrons that use the bar. The phenomenal thing about concrete is that the colors that I can dye the concrete are as myriad as a rainbow. The draws, I made this whole thing out of pallets. The cover to the refrigerator, I made that out of the wood that they had left over. So there's a lot of advantages to the concrete bar. You can mold it to whatever size you want. You can design it whatever size you want. You're not restricted by any kind of sizing, as long as you put the proper rebar in it.
Like, the cleanup is easy as shit. And mainly the only thing you have to worry about is scratches here and there, but that's like nothing compared to all the other stuff you have to worry about with a regular wooden bar, you know?
Right. Things unsnapped, gets removed, and then this thing hinges out of the way. And now you can slide the doors closed, and then when you want to put it back for when the bar is open during the night, that's a full thing. This thing hinges closed like this. This thing slides over.
You got to try this out, right?
This thing gets put in here, and I engineered this so it was an easy one-stop move, and anyone could do it. And there it is.
So when you're working, you know, you can use it as one full bar.
When this half of the bar is closed during the day, they put the doors across, and this is animals, that's just a daily thing. And then sometimes when they have private parties, they split the bar in half, and that's where we have the doors and the separation. The custom things I put in the bar, I put sea glass into the bar around a border. I have put, I've made impressions with bones and fossils into it to make it look like an old fossil. I have put into it little geometric squares and half moons in it. Like I said, the great thing about concrete is that we were able to build an insert for this and put a drain in the concrete so that they didn't have to buy or attach to the back of this the drain for the drink overflowing the ice on it. Made these boxes to store stuff at the bar when they needed to have the band set. Designed this door, old-fashioned door with a roller. These wheels are really cool looking, but they're actually wheels from a clothesline. That's a clothesline wheel up there. But the size and the look of it is really old looking and great. Build these steps for them. They want something that looked like that's been here forever. So I said, let's build it out of cedar. It'll get beat up really quick and look like it's been here forever. We put in flower boxes on the side. These windows as well, these custom windows that they wanted to make them look really old. These windows and these are the doors that I built for them.
All right, Moxie, let's start off with two dashes of Angostura bourbon, or bitters, a little splash of club soda. I'm gonna use 2 ounces house bourbon. We're gonna use 1/4 ounce Chinar.
I get a sip yet.